week is Devin Singletary. He looked real good a week ago with almost 160 yards. It's the Giants and the Eagles on Thursday night.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. But tonight we kick off week six with a great Thursday night matchup as it'll be the New York Giants taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Eagles team as they interplay here. They're off to a terrific start, unbeaten at 5-0 through the first month and change.
And you can hang a lot of this early success on their defense, too. They're the tone setters for these guys, and the entire team feeds off of what they do.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Giants, they, too, were winners last time out, so something's got to give here.
And I love it when both teams come in off of wins. Great mindsets, and it usually leads to a really well-played game.
McCole Hardman to return it from his end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. They'll be led out by a Heisman runner-up during his college days. It's the versatile Jalen Hurts.
Tremendous production in college at two different universities, and this is a guy who was a finalist for the Heisman Trophy. Still much more of a runner than a thrower, but has plenty of arm and is capable of making the big throws downfield. And don't underestimate his ability to think the game. Remember, he's the son of a coach.
A pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
And here, Charles, is a look at the inactive, some of the guys that are out today due to injury.
Yeah, and this is where the preseason work comes into play for some of those backups. It's not just them getting some experience on the field, but preparing each week in practice as if they were going to play. And when you have guys like that on your team, you've got a chance for success when the injury bug hits.
Officially nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down.
Now right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains.
Hurts. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. 21 yards there on third down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Now Hurts on the option right. That's a good acceleration there as he's across midfield to the 48-yard line.
Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane, and he keeps it himself there and worked out well.
How about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and ran. Let's face it, most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us, need to get him going, runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed. But they
under pressure, and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw up a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. Short completion, just 4 yards. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
Throwing is Hurts. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. That one good for only six, and it leaves him with a fourth down. Now Jake Elliott, earlier in his career, he beat these Giants with a 61-yarder. The kick by Elliott is good, and the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead.
Well, they started the drive backed up pretty deep, but a nice effort to overcome the field position, get into field goal range on the game's opening possession.
And Brandon, I think from where they started, the initial thought was, can we get one or two first downs and help out our defense after we pump the ball away with field position? But as that drive went on, I think their sights got set a little bit higher. They were thinking touchdown, ended up settling in between and coming away with a field goal.
So here are the Giants ready to start their initial drive of the game. And leading them out there, we get a look at their 6'3 quarterback.
His ability to adjust on the fly is almost unmatched in the game right now, because it leads to a couple of snaps per game where you just sit back and ask yourself, how did he pull that off? Opponents can practice and prepare each and every week all they want, but this guy, he is hard to corral.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down. We know they have these RPOs in their playbook, and look, we're seeing it here in the first quarter. You think we're going to see it as the game continues?
They trotted them out early for a reason, partner. They're letting them know that this is in the arsenal and we rely on it. You better be prepared, because this is...
Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Well, you don't usually get a sack from a nose tackle spot, but we got one there.
No, we don't. And a lot of the times in passing situations, they end up off the field anyway. So how happy was he to work his way back to the quarterback and put him on the ground? He's going to end up with a nickname after something like that, some big jelly or something like that.
Looking to throw on second down. McCarthy out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. Just a one-yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a third and long. You look at this Eagle defense. This unit against the pass, hoping to get better for sure. Number 25 in the NFL right now.
And that right there is what they're going to need to do, because this is not an elite unit. They've got to keep everything in front of them, rally up, and make plays. What a lot of defensive coordinators call top-down defense. Don't give up anything behind you.
5 yards, and that means they come up short as they're going to have to punt here on the opening drive. On fourth down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. And he was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away.
Hardman on the return.
Nowhere to go that time. It's a 46-yard punt with a loss on the return. And the Eagles will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. And that's out to the flat for Swift.
They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
So, Charles, you look at this offense. What a start to the season. 5 wins without a loss. When do you think that you start believing that maybe you're in the midst of something special?
Well, you and I both know every head coach never wants that thought to creep into a locker room. But the truth of the matter is, not quite at this time, because if we look at the Steelers in 2020, they're a great example. Remember, they started 11-0, then lost 5 of 6 and went out in the first round. But I think if you get toward mid-November, the Thanksgiving time frame, and you're still doing this, that's when things start to get real for a while.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. At that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Returnable here for Davis. Nice punt, but good work on the return to get back 11 yards. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. So the Giants getting the football back here for their second drive.
They come off a victory over the weekend, but now the quick turnaround here for this Thursday night game. How does that affect how teams like this approach these short turnarounds?
Well, wins and losses always factor into, you know, how you're getting ready for the next game. But equally as important, when you have the short turnaround, What is your injury situation? Are you losing key guys? And if so, how well have the backups prepared for this? Because you don't have much time to get them ready. They have to be ready before this week in order to play well in this game.
To throw on second down, McCarthy. Open target here, Darius Slayton. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. His first catch, good for 16 and a first.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll run on first down with Singletary. And tough sliding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
3-0 after one on EA Sports. Giant football, and we're ready to begin the second quarter as they're looking at a second down and 9 to go. Back to throw, McCarthy. And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. Nolan Smith brings him down to the pass rush.
Pressure can jump him all over when applying a defensive strategy. And that particular play just came from the outside.
A tough spot here. Third and 15. Operating from the gun, McCarthy being chased out left. The scramble good for a nice gain of 10 yards, but still fourth down.
I thought he did a pretty good job there to get back what he could, but let's face it, that sack on second down, talk about throwing a wrench into the works. It certainly did.
Yeah, he did everything he could there, trying to pick up some positive yardage, and he did, but not enough.
Field goal try. On the left hash, this from 48 yards. Fairbairn able to put this one through. So he's been automatic to this point in the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
Field goals all we've had so far. 3-3 now as the kick is away. Hardman going to bring it out of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee. Maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession.
As mentioned, this one of the hottest teams in the NFL, riding that winning streak into this one. But now playing here on Thursday night, do you think that this helps or hurts their momentum?
Well, ordinarily, I'd say it hurts the momentum because now you've got that short week. But when a team's playing as well as they are, it actually allows them to down focus and only worry about themselves and less about their opponent. So when you're playing well, you just worry about the things you're doing well and let the opponent deal with that.
Here's second and 3. Swift going to try up the middle. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. That one, a first down pickup of 8. The Eagles at a perfect 5-0 here to begin the campaign. And they've certainly found their groove of late, winners of 5 in a row.
And this team is absolutely playing their best football right now. This is the best that we've seen them play in a long time, partner. sky's the limit as far as they're concerned. Their confidence really soaring.
And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
And he is going to lose yardage here. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Hurt sets up to throw it. Short throw to Smith. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days. But you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target. And that's how he'll shred a defense.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They go play action with Hurts. Looking left sideline, incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. Open man, that's Devontae Smith. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 20-yard line. But following the play now, they're going to stop the clock here as a man is shaken up. Hopefully, obviously, nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break. Now Hurts going to get this to his running back, Swift, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards, and they'll be left with a second and about a foot.
Some of the slack, because remember the last drive they went 3 and out.
Here's Hurts to throw. Flush to his right. What was he thinking there? It's easily intercepted. Brandon Jones picking it off. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Giants touchdown. So from one end zone all the way to the other. Talk about a turnaround.
And how about the excitement that play generates for his team? Not just the points on the board, but the momentum and taking it from coast to coast, end zone to end zone. What a tremendous play. Now get that man an oxygen tent.
That's your boy Old Mo, you said momentum, right?
Old Mo, I think he's kind of limping across at the end because of that distance, but he made it.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Eagles offense back out onto the field. And it's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
They start the drive here with Gainwell up to the 20.
Well, how about the big guy there showing some agility? He just flowed from his D-tackle position in order to make that play.
Here's a second and 8. He'll drop to throw. Quick slant here to Smith. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Hurts finding Smith for the Philly first.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And a decent gain there as that takes us to the 2-minute warning. Second down, here's Hurts.
that's going to be incomplete.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass. They'll drop to throw. And he's caught. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. From the gun, it's Hurts. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. It actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line. Oh, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it. And the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy and can he step into a throw. And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
First down, Giants on a pickup of 14. Looking to throw. McCarthy. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
The defender certainly didn't forget about him leaking out of the backfield. There's a guy ready and waiting to pick him up in coverage. And that throw had no shot.
Throwing again. McCarthy. He's into space past the 25. And he will have a first down here as they get into field goal range, down just shy of the 20.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm. This guy's a good player. They've got to find him.
Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sacked back at the 29. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
A partner guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Now Kaimi Fairbairn for the field goal try. Made his first. This now from 46 yards away. The kick by Fairbairn is good. And they will stretch their lead to 10 now at 13-3. Well, they already had the early lead, and they get the interception, Charles, and now they add three more with the field goal.
Yeah, they're in control of how this game is playing out so far. You mentioned the early lead. Now they're expanding on it, getting plays on both sides of the ball. A winning recipe if they can keep this up.
Well, a dangerous return man showing it here. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And he'll bring it back all the way. Touchdown, Eagles.
Week after week, Charles, when we see this offense operate, I don't know, they just seem to get more impressive.
They certainly do, and let's face it, it's no surprise they're the best in the NFL in scoring. This team designs things well and executes even better. And here, it only takes a few snaps before they're in the end zone. That's how they demoralize teams. That's how they put them on notice.
Elliott good with a PAT. And the lead down to 3 and 13-10.
Time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kicks away. And we will not see an attempt to match that return touchdown as this will be a touchback and bring it out to the 25. The Giants with one final possession here in this first half.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now whistles here and a flag down. I think a giant jumped early. Maybe anticipating a blitz, and they jumped.
Yeah, and if we saw it, you know that they saw it. The bad guys might have been coming on that play. Had to pick them up, and they jumped.
Back to throw.
McCarthy.
He's got this complete to Robinson. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Throwing on first down.
McCarthy.
And this is taken in by Darnell Mooney. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. On the right hash, officially this will be a 51-yard attempt. The kick by Fairbairn is good, and that extends their advantage to six. It's 16-10.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
So we come upon halftime here with a bit.
Message received here. No need to wait. We're going to skip halftime and get right back to the action. Here comes the third quarter.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. Second half ready to get rolling. The Giants with a lead, and they are set to receive this kick. And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line. So now the Giants set to take over on offense. They were winners last week against Cincinnati, and right now they are in the driver's seat in this ball game as well. The third quarter starts with a run by Singletary. Muscles him off. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense. Walk out here,
man. So they'll get the yardage on the run and get 15 more for good measure.
Yeah, that wasn't too difficult to spot. You heard the sideline erupting. The flags came out almost immediately.
Giant player here, slow to get up after that last play.
While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. This second and 4.
Singletary, they'll go up the middle. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still had the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from the lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Now on third down, that pass knocked down in the backfield, incomplete.
Well, he certainly didn't like what he saw all from the coverage on his primary reads, and he didn't even have any luck trying to get back to a safety valve. Give defense a credit. Coverage was in lockdown mode everywhere.
And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin them back. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36.
Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give an enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the big fellas up front.
And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Now we'll get a stoppage here as it appears we've got an Eagle slow to get up.
The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. They're going to look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that.
And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line.
Dexter Lawrence able to bust free and get to the quarterback.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football, had to eat it, and ended up on the ground.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. Play action. Here's Hurts.
Under pressure, they got him again.
Now whistles and a stoppage here. Looks like one of the Eagles is in some discomfort out there. Well, the medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break.
And this one is no good. He missed it. And the deficit will stay at 2 field goals. So first and goal quickly turns into fourth and goal, and then fourth and goal turns in to no points whatsoever.
That's a very disappointing sequence of events right there. And I, for one, would not want to be the kicker as to run over to his head coach and explain that one.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
Looking deep here from Mooney. No points last time out. They were forced to punt, if you remember, but no time to dwell on that. They've still got the lead here and a chance to add to that here. First and 10 as this new drive starts. Second and 10.
On the counter, this is Singletary. He stiff arms him.
And he'll push forward for a couple to the 34.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, and you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
They take a shot downfield there, and it winds up falling incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Now a hit and a loose football. And the Giants have it. It's picked up. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. Why we saw that field goal try a moment ago, I'll never understand. But as a result, this offense, they've got to be pumped. First and 10 in striking position already. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just 1. Hold everything, because Darren Waller, the tight end, appears to be injured on that play.
Now second and 9. Now Browning.
And he'll find Everett there, complete. So he'll be stopped here for no gain. And that's going to set up a tough 3rd and 9.
That was impressive to me, because while it was a pass play, they still rallied to the football like they were filling running lanes. And they were able to put the receiver on the ground.
Here's Browning.
And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32.
Brought down by multiple defenders, and it's a loss of 12.
Now Kaimi Fairbairn for the field goal try. It'll be a 49-yard attempt from the left hash. Fairbairn able to put this one through, and that will make this a 9-point lead.
So the lead grows here incrementally, but I think the way their defense is playing, you feel okay with just getting 3.
They've definitely been stout so far, but now that can all change, because if one guy gets loose for 70 yards, this is a different game. But as it stands, field goals are good. Just keep adding to that lead.
And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And they've got to be a little bit frustrated about that last drive, missed field goal.
Always hurts a team because, you know, you've put something out there, you've given yourself a chance, you're in range, and the ball doesn't go through the post. But it's not something to panic about, I don't believe. Just keep playing and keep going.
Call that a very strong gain of 24. The play fake. Here's Hurts. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. They get to him for a loss of four, and it brings up third down on the sack.
Going to need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. Touchdown! Devontae Smith. His first touchdown on the year. And the Eagles have got it back to within a score. But not only, Charles, did he beat double coverage to make the catch, and then as soon as he did, locked his gaze upfield and made sure to reach the end zone.
Go grab your dictionary, partner. Look up determination, and his picture is going to pop right up. How about him getting through multiple defenders, finding his way through coverage, and making sure he got to the end zone? That's a big-time play right there.
Probably a good on the extra point. And the lead is down to two. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line. The New York set to take the field. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. Singletary to get the drive started. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. To throw, Browning. A little short pass. This is Everett. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. From the gun on third down, Browning. He's got his running back out of the backfield. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Well, that flag puts him on their heels a little bit more defensively as the officials walk it upfield.
Yeah, and they can blame the officials all they want, but bottom line, it's their own fault because, to me, that was an avoidable call. Stay focused and avoid major mistakes like that.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Offense. No.
Let's go. Andrew Thomas, former first rounder from Georgia, called for the penalty there. Singletary here running out of the gun. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of two there, second down.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Greg Newsom. And the Eagles are going to take over here up near the 40. Well, really not much secret there. Third and long, Charles, and he was looking to throw the football. And I would imagine as a defender, you're kind of salivating in that spot, right?
You certainly are, because third and long situations, they tip the scale towards the defense every single time. Now you're actually able to dictate and understand what the offense is trying to do. You know where the first down marker is. You set your defense that way. And maybe you can be a little more aggressive in certain situations because of that. You start focusing on your coverage assignment, and when the ball's released, you break on it and make a play, as we just saw there.
One quarter remains here on this Thursday night. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's been a good one so far. Just a two-point game here as we get set for quarter number four. Here's second and ten. Throwing is Hurts. Escaping the pressure right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Given 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
They're not out of it yet, but in order to come back, they need him to play clean football the rest of the way. He makes the correct read there, passing on challenging a blanket coverage and getting the first down with his legs instead.
Airing it out deep for Smith. And this one is incomplete.
That was for the lead right there. They know they're in a position where fortune favors the brave, so they took their shot but couldn't connect.
Hurts. And his throw here is incomplete.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches have told me in the past. The biggest teaching point, get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Out of the gun now on third down. And Hurts is intercepted, his third of the game. It's Deontay Banks with it. And the Giants are going to take over here up near the 40. One side gets an interception, but their defense comes on the field and picks them right back up by getting a pick of their own.
And I think you saw the same thing that I did, Brandon. As he ran off the field after making that play, we saw his quarterback seeking that one off the first of thank you to bail him out a little bit as the offense takes the field again.
No gain, and it's second down. Now a second and 10. The center receiver in motion to the right. That's complete to Slayton. Down to the 10. Touchdown, Giants. Darius Slayton, his second touchdown on the season. And the Giants use the big play to extend their fourth quarter lead. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And that makes this a nine-point game. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. Here's Mecole Hardman taking it about the one. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. Well, that last touchdown we just saw, what an important one. Now it's back to a two-score deficit for this crew as they take the field here, and they are in desperate need of finding the end zone. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I'm not even sure I know who this guy is out there playing right now. This is very unlike him, one of the most accurate guys in the league. Totally off his game right now.
I don't know. I was going to ask you what you pin it on, but defensively, they've been pretty solid.
Well, sometimes, you know, those defenders, they get into the receivers pretty well, and if they chip away at their timing, it's going to affect what you're doing throwing the ball as well. Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
They go play action with Hurts. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Going for the knockout blow right there. I think if I'm up two scores, I'd be worried about an interception, but playing this way is what got him this lead. So you may as well ride it out to the end.
His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. 3 on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over. And the Giants ready to come out now. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Well, the first play of the drive lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on 2nd and 14. Singletary again. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. So that one will get him halfway to the first down marker. 7 yards, makes it 3rd and 7 now. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. On 3rd down, Browning. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now,
and all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. But it looks like one of the DBs has it.
And that's what friends are for.
As the returner, you know who you're buying dinner for later.
Oh, without a doubt, because he just took care of you and your team in a big way. You know, you turned it over there, that's a big momentum changer and put your defense in a bad spot.
Hurts throw complete there to Smith. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. Catch is made by Hardman. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 23 yards on the play. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, 1st and 10 at the 46. Here's Hurts to throw. And he whips that one incomplete there.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still 2 more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
2nd down, here's Jalen Hurts. He's got Smith here. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. On 1st and 10, it's Hurts. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
Under 4 to go now as they come up on 2nd down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call.
Offense.
Well, your QB's been sacked 4 times in the game already, and they're the holding call.
And you know darn well the offensive line coach is frustrated and upset that he's been hit that many times already. He doesn't really care that they hold now. Just don't let him get hit anymore.
2nd down. Here's Hurts. And he fires one incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
The Eagles on 3rd down. They've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This will be 3rd and forever. Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on 3rd.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. And probably not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. And that'll move them back within six now. All right, so they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at least a three and out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. Right now, clinging to a one-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that four-minute offense with a little less than 4 minutes to go applies here, right?
It certainly does, and that means the playbook is still wide open. But you are a little bit more careful about what you're calling. You want plays that are going to gain yardage, how would you say, consistently, right? You don't need the big shots downfield, but make sure the clock continues to run. Pile up the first downs, and the goal? End the game with your quarterback kneeling down at the end, and you still have the lead.
10 yards, good for a Giant first down.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. Ball on the 40 now. Here's second and six. They go right back to Singletary. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. On third down, they go with Singletary. And the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's Jamie Gillen now as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And a fair catch called for and made at the 12-yard line. Hurts and the Eagles now down by six, a minute 44 to go. Their five-game winning streak hanging in the balance here. He's back to throw. And that's complete to Brown. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Back to throw. Flushed out right. And this one complete to Smith. And he's brought down. Well, they have had no answer for this connection all night long.
They just have to think in a two-minute situation. That's got to be a concentration lapse. You know they're going to go back to him with the game that he's been having.
Looking here for Smith downfield. And that is incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
A little more than 40 seconds to play. Now second and 10. They'll look to throw. He's going deep for Brown. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
He'll look to throw. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. And he stopped up short of the first as they tackle him down at about the 36. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. They're going on fourth down with Hurts. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. Fourth down trailing in the fourth quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I'd look down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays that have been successful throughout the game that have worked at the distance you need, and that's exactly what they got done.
This ball intercepted. It's Deontay Banks with it. And the Giants have just about sewn up this football game.
Just when you thought this game might be turned on its ear, a late interception pretty much going to seal the deal.
Yeah, boy, talk about having your backs to the wall. This defense, they looked like they were in danger of surrendering this lead, but they knew they needed that one play, and they got it right there, partner.
Well, this ball game was close throughout. Remember, it was neck and neck at intermission, neck and neck at the end, but a great job to come in here in a tough environment, Charles, and get the victory.
Yeah, tough environment indeed. How about all the people we can hear shouting from their seats right below us, partner? They weren't real happy that their team didn't keep the home field. How about how these visitors came in, calm every step of the way, even with all the pressure,